morning, Eastview. Starring Sir Smokey the Dog. Featuring the research space full of rigor news team. And now, ready, steady, go! It's Good Morning, Eastview.
Good morning, Eastview, and welcome back to Studio 124. I'm Hannah.
And I'm Sebastian. Along for the ride is Mega Puppy and inspirational poet, Sir Smokey the Dog.
Thanks, team. So next time you feel that need to stay in your comfort zone, see if all you really need is some confidence of your own. Daddy-o.
Smokey! Today we are going to talk about something serious. It's a form of bullying called cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is done on the internet, and it is not a good thing to do.
Did you know that 160,000 students do not go to school every day here in America because they are afraid of being attacked by another student?
On the internet means World Wide Web.
You know it as the www part of a web address.
Yeah, www means World Wide Web. 42% of students polled said that they had been bullied online. Indirect bullying is when people hack into your social media like Facebook and start sending mean messages to all your friends so the messages would look like they came from you.
Well, there was this girl and she started to make fun of me because I'm kind of tall. She got all of her friends to tease me about it. And then all of a sudden, I just felt like I didn't want to go to school anymore.
Unfortunately, because of cyberbullies, these days it's kind of like the wild, wild web. Communication, texts, and messages can easily get out of control. We kids sometimes can get isolated.
That means we are all by ourselves because people say or do mean things to us online. We feel all alone. We are being bullied. At home, we are alone on our computers and cell phones as we text and chat.
People can make up very mean things and post them to the internet. That not only makes us feel bad, but makes other people think bad things about us, and what they're saying just isn't true. It's mean, it's hurtful.
It might even make you feel not worth very much. You stop wanting to do anything. You stop wanting to go to school or outside. You feel very sad.
I don't have a lot of friends because I'm new this year. Last night when I was texting, somebody texted me over and over saying they had something to tell me. After like the fifth time, I answered and it said, and they texted back, "Everybody hates you." I read it once and I thought about it over and over. And I thought, I think everybody should hate me.
If bullying happens at school or in the neighborhood, it can make you feel lost. If it continues at home on the computer through inappropriate texting or chat, you might feel like there's nowhere to go for help.
Cyberbullies are the most cowardly type of bullies because they hide behind their keyboards without people knowing who they are. They can't see the pain in your face or the sad look in your eyes.
Out of shame or guilt, you might say to your parents,
"No, Mom, don't do or say anything about the bullying. You'll just make it worse."
Someone broke into my Facebook account and sent me emails to all my friends. They all hate me now because they think I was rude to them. I don't know what to do. My mom would only make it worse, and they'd probably get even more mad at me. There's no way to stop this. Is there?
So, what can you do so that this does not happen to you?
1. Tell your parents. They really do want you to be safe. This form of bullying is not just kids being kids. It's cruel, it's unfair, and it's mean.
2. Let your teacher, your principal, or school counselor know what is going on any adult you feel comfortable with or you trust. Adults do get it and they do care.
Telling is not tattling. Bullying is wrong. Just make sure that you never bully the person back. Then you are at fault as much as the bully.
4. Words are powerful. And when you say things that cut into someone, it changes who they are. It changes their personality. It changes their future. It changes the way they might raise their own kids.
You are not alone. Together we can all make a difference. If you are being harassed online, it's a cyberbully. Report it.
Hello, America, and all ships descend. It's time for a special segment of Good Morning Eastview called Smokey's Clip of the Week.
Now, my whole house is great. I can do anything good. I like my school. I like anything. I like my dad. I like my cousins. I like my aunts. I like my Allisons. I like my mom. I like my sisters. I like my dad. I like I like my hair. I like my haircuts. I like my pajamas. I like my stuff. I like my rooms. I like my home. My whole house is great. I can do anything good. Yeah. I can do anything good. Better than anyone. Better than anyone.
That's about it for Good Morning Eastview this week. I'm Sebastian.
And I'm Hannah. Protect yourself from cyberbullies. Tell your parents, your teacher, or any adult you trust.
For all the morning crew here at 540 Longwood Drive, don't be the last to know what's going on. And I'm Smokey.
Always the last to know how you're feeling. The last to know.
Go ahead, Smokey. Say what you wanted to say.
Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened.